The Milky Way galaxy is a huge collection of stars. If you could view the galaxy from the top or bottom, it would look like a spinning pinwheel. And our Sun is located on one of the spiral arms, about 25,000 light years away from the center of the galaxy. If you look up on a clear night sky, the Milky Way galaxy will be visible to the naked eye as a hazy form of stars. But that's just 0.000003% of it that is visible. If you got out on a dark night, you can see thousands of stars. But the Milky Way has 200 billion stars in it. Not all are visible even to the best of telescopes. And now, scientists have discovered a region within the Milky Way that is very, very strange. Scientists have discovered a huge extragalactic structure hidden behind the Milky Way in a mysterious area of the sky known as the zone of avoidance because it is obscured by our own galaxy's opaque bulge. What is this structure? Why did it remain hidden for so long? And what is hiding within this unknown region? This is how scientists discovered a huge extragalactic structure in a hidden region of space.
Orbit beyond the blue.
The star stuff that makes up our Milky Way is distributed inside a thin plane that orbits around a central bulge that contains the supermassive black hole, Sagittarius A. The galactic plane and bulge are packed with stars, dust, and gas that block our view of whatever is on the other side. Scientists have been able to use different wavelengths to peer through this zone of avoidance, a region that obscures 10 to 20% of the sky. But despite their best efforts and use of advanced tech, most of this region still remains out of our view. If an alien colony had to hide in our galaxy, perhaps this blind spot would be the best place. This new galaxy cluster, named VVV-JKB-18143538142, is located behind the Milky Way bulge and helps to complete the picture of the large-scale structure in this still little explored area of the sky. Daniela Galdiano, an astronomer at the National University of San Juan in Argentina, who reported the discovery, says, "This result is very satisfying for us. For many years, the zone of avoidance had a lack of information. But now with new studies, we could cover a little region of the sky. And in the near future, a bigger region with data." The team estimated that the cluster contains about 58 galaxies. But it will take many more observations to be certain of its contents. The discovery of this cluster offers an exciting glimpse behind the Milky Way, and scientists will need to continue pulling back this curtain in order to understand our place in space. In addition to hidden galaxy clusters, the zone of avoidance also contains the bizarre Great Attractor, an unidentified gravitational anomaly that is pulling all galaxies and clusters toward it. The nature of this huge attractor is a mystery that can only be solved by more observations and research. And the study of the newly discovered galaxy cluster will put us one step closer to solving the mystery. So yes, if an alien colony had to hide in our galaxy, perhaps the zone of avoidance would allow for maximum secrecy. Which is why the scientists conducting the study reveal that they are prepared to be quote-unquote surprised, to say the least. But say an alien species had to hide somewhere even closer to the one confirmed planet with life in our galaxy, then the best spot would be somewhere around the solar system. Two words, Kuiper Belt. The Kuiper Belt is vast and mysterious, extremely cold and dark. A perfect hiding place for an alien species, should it wish to hide near our solar system. Many of the belt's components are small, with diameters between 100 and 1500 kilometers, what are essentially believed to be the remnants of the solar system formation. Abandoned space rocks that had nowhere to go ended up in the Kuiper Belt. Had Neptune not been there, these objects might have had a real chance at becoming a planet. but Neptune's gravity grounded their dream of ever becoming anything more. Astronomers believe that many of the icy objects lying in the Kuiper Belt, sitting on the outermost reaches of our galaxy, may be hosting alien invaders that are slowly making their way towards our star system from another star. Since all this remains speculation till now, is there actually a way to study this cold, dark, distant region? Maybe. Consider for a moment just how much lighting we here on Earth produce. Picture how our night side appears when viewed from a space-bound observatory like the International Space Station or even a distant space telescope. The same way, if we can assume that alternate civilizations would evolve from enjoying just their natural lighting, wouldn't it be okay to also assume they might also develop artificial lighting sources? Then, is it possible for us to peer into space and spot artificially illuminated objects that are out there? Two scientists think so. Harvard's Avi Loeb and Princeton's Edwin L. Turner think it's worth considering and studying. For gathering light, the array of earthly telescopes now at science's disposal are able to confidently observe a light source comparable in overall brightness to a large city up to a certain distance. Right now, astronomers are able to measure the orbital parameters of Kuiper Belt objects BOSS with the greatest of precision by their observed flux and computing their changing orbital distances. However, is it possible to see light if it were to occur on the dark side? Loeb and Turner say that current optical telescopes and surveys would have the ability to see this amount of light at the edge of our solar system, and observations with large telescopes can measure a KBOS spectra to determine if they are illuminated by artificial lighting using a logarithmic slope. While most of the Kuiper Belt objects are believed to be the remnants from the formation of our solar system, there are some with unusually elongated orbits whose presence cannot be explained. One such example is the newly discovered mini planet, Cydna. Astronomers studying the Kuiper Belt say that objects like Cydna may have come from another star during a close encounter with our Sun. Perhaps when the stars were still young, only about tens of millions of years old, and residing in a densely populated cluster. However, the presence of any biological signs of life have yet not been conclusively determined. Computer simulations performed by experts demonstrate that a passing star's gravity may have activated the Kuiper Belt. Some of the objects may have been thrown out and instigated into forming large, eccentric orbits. To find out if this is truly the case or not, astronomers are trying to observe distant objects in the Kuiper Belt with similar orbits to Cydna. Orbits that are steep and elliptical. If they are successful at finding more objects similar to Cydna, it will infer that they all originally orbited another star. An alien star. That is a topic of discussion for another day. Till then, here's hoping scientists uncover the mystery of the hidden galaxy cluster, as well as the Kuiper Belt, but what do I know?
Beyond the blue.